So, Ciarán Cóirlí, I want to deal with an issue which hasn't featured very much to date in this debate, but is an issue that needs to be spoken about. It's the question of worker exploitation at the National Children's Hospital project site. And this is an issue which must be dealt with and stopped wherever the hospital ends up being built, whether it's the James's site, whether it's a Greenfield site, whether it's Connolly Hospital or what have you. Now, the contractor at the site is BAM. BAM have a network of subcontractors. One of the subcontractors they use frequently is a company called Quick Structures. In this House on February 7, 2018, my colleague Deputy Paul Murphy said that that company was responsible for illegal super-exploitation of construction workers, many of them migrants. At BAM projects in Grange Gorman, student accommodation, and at Boland's Mill. He instanced the fact that they were paying on those sites much less than the SEO for construction, that workers were not being provided with payslips, and they were not contributing to the construction industry pension scheme. Now, since then, Quick Structures have moved on site at James's, at the National Children's Hospital. I asked the Minister, has any action been taken on foot of the charges made by Deputy Murphy in the Dáil over a year ago now? Is this company now paying employers PRSI? Is it providing its workers with payslips? Has it declared fully the income tax on P60s? Does it have offshore accounts to avoid paying tax? Have you looked into this matter over the course of the last year? Or, as I suspect, is it the case that you don't want to look under that particular rock as you are afraid of what you might see? This is an issue which has importance in and of itself, but it's also an issue which has a wider importance, because the National Children's Hospital is meant to be the jewel in the crown for €115 billion worth of national development project. The standards for this national development project are meant to be set at the National Children's Hospital. So what's the position here regarding worker exploitation? The government, the revenue commissioners and the Department of Social Protection, in my mind, are turning a blind eye to it. They're showing a reckless disregard for workers' rights and a scandalous dereliction of duty in terms of collecting tax revenue for society. Sections of the media have tried to make out that construction wage costs are a factor in the overruns. They are not. The entry-level wage rate for a construction worker is £28,000 per year. This is a sector of the economy which has seen record profits, €1 billion up in 2018 from what it was in 2017. The issue is not workers being paid too much. The issue is worker exploitation and super-exploitation, and it's alive and well on that construction site. For these reasons, we support the 12% wage claim over 3 years that the construction unions have submitted, and we support their claim for a one-hour daily travel allowance. In conclusion, we will be supporting this motion. We think the points that have been raised by Deputy Smith about the review being time-limited are very important points. There should be no suspension of employment for any worker in the event of a suspension. And the issues of the cost of the project and the accessibility have to be important factors in that. Thank you.
Deputy Joan